Hey, what's up, everybody? It's Amrinder Singh. Today, we'll talk about masculine and feminine words. So, how would you know what word is masculine and what word is feminine in Punjabi? Well, it's kind of hard because you have to go through the process. You have to learn the Punjabi language step by step. So, with the practice, that's how would you know. But there's a way you can find some Punjabi words. So those are feminine or masculine. There's a tip. That's what I'm gonna tell you in this video. And another thing, all color names in Punjabi are masculine, but sometimes we use them as a feminine. So why is that? We will also talk about this in this video. So before I start the lesson, I wanna let you know that if your goal is to learn conversational Punjabi, then you are on the right place, because on this channel, that's what I teach. I teach conversational Punjabi and tell the difference between a textbook type Punjabi and the real conversational Punjabi. So let's get started. So when it comes to masculine and feminine words, so there's no specific rules in Punjabi, so you can guess it's a masculine word or it's a feminine word. But if a word is ending with like a sound, that word is mostly going to be a masculine. If a word which is ending with like an E sound, that word is going to be a feminine word. Like kutta. Kutta means dog. Kutti. Kutti means female dog, right? So kutta is going to end with A. So this is a masculine word. Kutti, right? It's going to end with E sound. Then it's feminine word, alright? Another example. Kursi. Kursi means chair. So kursi is going to end with E sound. Kursi is C, is E at the end, right? So it's feminine word. Another word, kamara. Kamara means room, right? So it's kamara. It's going to end with ra sound. Ra, a, a, ra, right? So kamara. It's ending with a sound, so it's masculine word. Another word, kala. Kala. Kala means black. Ka la is la sound. A. It's again it's ending with a sound, so it's masculine word. So there's also other words which are not ending with R E sound. So in that situation, it's a little hard for you guys because there are no specific rules for those words. So you have to like learn those words through your process, right? When you're repeating it, when you listen to somebody, you can see is those person is using those words as a masculine or feminine. So that's how would you learn those words. So let's take another word, sher. Sher means lion, so it's a masculine. So but it's not ending with a sound. It's not shera, right? It's sher. It's ending with schwa sound. Sher, right? So how would you know it? You would know it through your learning process. When you're listening to Punjabi people, are they using this word as a masculine or a feminine? That's how would you know. Next word is kitab. Kitab means book, and kitab is a feminine word, but it's not ending with e sound. It's not kitabi, it's kitab, right? So it's ending with ub sound, it's schwa sound, kitab, right? But it's a feminine word. So how would you know it? You would know when somebody, Punjabi native speaker, is speaking. Are they using this word for as a like a masculine or feminine, right? That's what you know. And another thing I wanna let you know, that the all color names are masculine, like a lal, right? Even lal, lal means red. So it's not a sound, like it's not lala, right? So it's lal. So it's end with swa sound, right? Lal. So here's no a sound, but it's masculine. So how would you know it? I don't know, but the all color name are masculine, right? Keep in mind. So when you are pronouncing your color names, or you are using color name in the sentence, so those all color names are masculine, right? And another thing, keep in mind, like I told you, all color name is masculine, but sometimes it depends on the thing you are like describing. It could be a feminine, for example, right? So if you're talking about a car, right? Car is a feminine word. So you bought a like a white car, right? So it's not going to be a chitta. So chitta means white. So you won't use chitta here. So you would use chitti, chitti car, right? White car. So why is chitti? Because this is, you are talking about car, and car is a feminine word. So if you are talking about a truck, truck is a masculine word. So that time you would use chitta, right? So it's awesome. So that time you would use a masculine color name, chitta truck, right? Why is that? Because we are talking about a truck. Truck is a masculine word. If you're only talking about a color name, that time all color name is masculine. For example, if I ask you like, what's your favorite color, right? And your favorite color is blue. That time you would say nila, right? Nila. So it's mean blue. You won't say nili. You won't say that because you're talking about a color name. All color names are masculine when you are talking about only color name. If you are describing a specific thing, that time it depends on that thing. Like again, if you are talking about car, it's a blue car, then you would use is nili. You won't use nila. You would say nili car. You won't say nila car. If you say nila car, that's so weird. So if you see car, car is a feminine word, but it's not ending with e sound. So how would you know it? You would know it through the learning process. So how would you know with learning process? For example, if I'm using car, right, car word in sentence, so pay attention, I'm using it for as masculine or feminine. For example, a car bahut soni hai, right? So how would you know it's masculine or feminine? It's feminine because I said soni hai. I use soni for car, right? So it's feminine. If it's masculine, then I would use sona, right? So which means it's beautiful car. Like for truck, I would say a sona truck ka, right? This truck is beautiful. So truck is a masculine word, so that's why you use sona. Car is a feminine word, that's why you use soni, right? So that's how would you know what I'm using it as a masculine or feminine. And last thing, keep in mind, not every word who is ending with a sound is a masculine. Even not every word who is ending with like an e sound is a feminine. There would be some words who are ending with a sound, they might be a feminine word. And there would be some words who are ending with e sound, they would be a masculine words. For example, hathi. Hathi means elephant. Hathi is ending with e sound, right? Hathi. But it is a masculine word. But these kind of words are very rare. Most of the time, the words who are ending with e sound, they are feminine. And the words who are ending with a sound, they are masculine. I think maybe 80 to 90% words who are ending with a sound, they are masculine. So anyway, guys, if you haven't subscribed my channel, then subscribe and press the notification bell button, because when I upload the new video, so you don't miss any. And if you want some extra Punjabi stuff, then check out my links. Links are in the description. So I hope you enjoyed the lesson. I'll be back with another lesson in another day.